Hello students, good morning. I am Jarina Bhuvar, working as an assistant professor in BBA department of Brahmanand Group of Colleges at Chapada. This video is for the students of BBA 3rd sem who are belongs to Bhaktkavi Narasimha Mehta University. Today, I will discuss about the subject Marketing Management. So, let's start the syllabus of Marketing Management. So, the subject Marketing Management contains 5 units. So, let's start with Unit 1st. Unit 1st is Introduction to Modern Marketing. In this unit, you will learn about 2 topics. Evolution of Marketing Concept and second one is Marketing Mix. So, first topic is Evolution of Marketing Concept. So, if we see from past to the present, marketing has to pass through various situations and various concepts are evolved, like production concept, product concept, selling concept, and finally marketing concept arrived. So, in first topic, evolution of marketing, you will learn about the history of the marketing concept. The second topic is marketing mix. So, what is marketing mix? Marketing mix means a set of marketing tools that firm uses to pursue its marketing objectives. In simple term, we can say marketing mix means 4 P's, that is product, price, promotion and place. Through these 4 P's, marketer will achieve its marketing objectives. So, unit 1, you will learn about evolution of marketing concept and marketing mix. Unit 2nd is product decisions. Product is the first P of marketing mix. We can say product is considered as a central part of all marketing activities. The other P's, that means price, promotion and place, will depend upon the product. For developing any kind of marketing strategies, the product is the most important tool. So, in this unit, you will learn about the first topic is product mix. That means you will learn product line, depth, width, consistency and what factors about affecting the product mix. In second topic is related. In second topic is a new product. In this topic, you will learn about the what is the need for a new product, why many new products are failed, what is the process of new product development, etc. Third topic, you will learn about the product life cycle. Product life cycle means all products have a specified length of life during which it passes through some specific stages like introduction, growth, maturity, saturation, declining, obsolescence, etc. So, in this topic, you will learn about the product life cycle. And fourth topic is consumer adoption process. It is the process through which a consumer makes decision whether to adopt or reject the product, to continue or to discontinue with the product. So, unit 2 contains these 4 topics: product mix, new product, product life cycle and consumer adoption. Unit 3, pricing decisions. Price is the second element of marketing mix. After selecting product, price is an important weapon in the hands of the marketers. So, in this unit, you will learn about the how to set price, price setting methods and important concepts related to pricing decisions. Unit 4. Unit 4 is related to market promotion decision. In market promotion is the third element of marketing mix. Without promotion, no product can be sold. So, through promotion mix, people come to know about the availability of the product in the market. So, in this unit, you will learn about the components of the promotion mix. That is advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, publicity and public relations. Unit 5, distribution decisions. In this unit, we will learn about physical distribution, channel of distribution and payment gateways. Okay, first is physical distribution. Physical distribution means movement of goods from the place of producer to customers. Second is channel of distribution. By this channel of distribution, product and services of producer reaches to the final hands of the consumers. In this unit, you will learn about the physical distribution, channel of distribution, and third one is payment gateways. Payment gateways is a merchant service provider that allows credit card, debit card for online business by an e-commerce service provider. It facilitates transactions between a payment portal. So, I have discussed the syllabus of the marketing management. In next lecture, we will start our first unit of marketing management. Thank you.